A quick introduction to mass. Now, in our language, we sometimes interchange the word mass and weight. That's okay, because we all understand what we mean. But I just thought I'd introduce to you, if you didn't know, weight is actually the force of gravity pushing down on an object. And that force, the weight of something, is measured using newtons, typically. Mass, on the other hand, is what we measure using grams and kilograms and tons, etc. So today, when you see the word mass, or when you hear me use the word mass, you probably heard it in a different context. So for example, if I wanted to weigh this egg, actually what I'm doing is finding out the mass of this egg. This egg has a mass of 54 grams. This bit of breakfast cereal has a mass of 1 gram. This bag of sugar has a mass of 1,000 grams. Typically, when we start looking at mass, we start with non-standard units of measure. A non-standard unit of measure can pretty much be anything. Standard units of measure, grams, kilograms, tons, whereas a non-standard unit of measure, well, it could be these plastic bricks. Because I could take my loaf tin here and say, right, well, how many plastic bricks will it take until I have the same mass as this loaf tin? I can measure the mass of this loaf tin using plastic bricks. I can measure the weight of this in these. How many until I have the same weight, until I have the same mass? They're not a standard unit of measure, they're plastic bricks. I could do the same using other non-standard units of measure. For example, I could grab forks. As long as the forks are the same size and shape, so that they each have the same mass as each other, I could use these. How many forks will I take until I get to the same mass as my loaf tin? 7? 8 forks? I can measure my loaf tin using a non-standard unit of weight. A non-standard unit of mass. A non-standard unit of measure. Cool. When starting, though, with standard units of measure, we look at grams, kilograms, and tons. As I said, grams are for really small things. This sugar, though, this weighs 1,000 grams, which is 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram is the same as 1,000 grams. And 1,000 kilograms is the same as a ton. So if I had 1,000 bags of sugar, I would have the same mass as a small family car that has a mass of 1 ton. So if you're looking at objects that are very small, use grams to measure them. If you're looking at objects that are quite big, use kilograms to measure them. If you're looking at objects that are huge, use tons to measure them. So you're looking at like ships, trucks, cars, tons, chairs, tables, kilograms, breakfast cereal, eggs, grams. Excellent. Then, finally, once you've got your head around all of that, often you'll be presented with maths problems using a scale that ask you to work out what the intervals are. If this is my weighing scale, and I've put my apple on the top, and the arrow has gone all the way around to point to there, I need to find out what the mass of the apple is by finding out what the missing number is. Now, you've got to work out what this is going up in jumps of. You can start by counting up in ones, or twos, or fives, or tens, or twenties, or twenty-fives, or fifties, or hundreds, or 250s, because those are the most typical intervals when looking at mass. However, there's a quicker way. Look at your end number, so you know that it maxes out at 80, and it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 intervals. So in fact, to work out what each interval is worth, I need to do the total divided by the parts. So 80 divided by the 8 intervals, which equals 10. Now I know that each of these is worth 10 grams. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Each of these intervals is worth 10 grams. And if my arrow is pointing there, then my apple must have weighed 50 grams. If you are getting a little bit confused by looking at it on a circular number line, because that's what this is essentially, draw your own. draw a flat number line with a 0 there and the 80 there, and do the same process, but maybe using a more familiar way of looking at it. So you've still got your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 intervals. You've still got your 80 at the end, but if you prefer to look at it like that as a flat number line, then do that instead. Now that's quite a lot to take in already. Have a look at the resources to, well, go over everything I've said already and push yourself forwards. Good luck and enjoy.